gotta put it in ya. Alright, fuck me.
Winter is when your battery works its hardest, and when it often fails. Norm Miller here, chairman of Interstate Batteries. Find out how much life your battery has left in it. Get it tested today at your neighborhood Interstate Batteries location. Find the one near you at interstatebatteries.com. Interstate Batteries, outrageously dependable.
This is Brian Benning, owner of Interstate Batteries in Edmonton. Before heading out on the road, get your car battery tested at any of our 1,000 dealers across northern Alberta.
The news you want, when you want it. This is iNews 880, Edmonton's only all-news radio station.
Take 80 time 8:09. Good morning, I'm Kim Smith. Well, a Canadian living in the biggest city affected by the meteor that streaked through the sky over Russia says he was terrified at first. Saskatoon native Michael Garnett, who plays hockey in the KHL, says he was jolted out of bed by a blast that shook his apartment building.
I got a car to drove around my building, and when I looked there was nothing there. I was just dumbfounded. I thought there would be, like, you know, an airplane or something in the side. That's how big a bang this was.
The fall of the meteor caused explosions that broke glass over a wide area, injuring some 500 people, most of whom sought treatment or cuts. Well, penguin at the Calgary Zoo has died after swallowing a large stick that it found in its exhibit. Fiona died in December, about 8 days after she had surgery to remove the 25-centimeter stick. Zoo curator Jamie Dorgan says the penguins seem to be recovering well, but 8 days after the operation, they found it dead in a holding room where it was being kept to recover. The penguins are curious, and they may have thought the stick was nesting material. I'm using 80 times 810.
Every month, I give the gift of sight by donating to Operation Eyesight, an organization working to restore and preserve vision in the developing world. I help prevent blindness. I know that every month, I help another person see again. It's a great feeling. Will you share that with me? For a donation as small as $30, you can restore a blind person's sight. Together, we can change lives. To learn how to give the gift of sight, please visit OperationEyesight.com.
When saving for this fit, you need $36. The 36-hour sale is on right now at Lazy Boy Furniture Gallery. Great savings store-wide. No interest, no admin fee financing. Choose from your favorite style. But hurry, with savings this good, they won't be around long. There's something for every room in your home. Quality furniture that lasts. Prices that won't. Lazy Boy Furniture Gallery, 36-hour sale. South Edmonton Common and West End on 170th Street. Lazy Boy Furniture Gallery. Live life comfortably.
However, we do have a freezing rain warning on our hands. Markets had an issue this yesterday because we have a warm front pushing in. With freezing temperatures at the surface, we could see freezing rain through the Edmonton area. Some areas are already reporting flurries this morning, so we just have a mixed bag on our hands for first thing. southwest winds will kick in, and then those nice temperatures for the afternoon. -4 for tomorrow morning. We do get to +3 with increasing cloud in the afternoon. And then we've got 3 in the forecast for the overnight into Sunday morning. Down to -4 Sunday, and then temperatures drop even further down to -7. Northwest winds at 30 kilometers an hour with a mix of sun and cloud by the afternoon. Monday, we start at -15, daytime highs of -12. With your exclusive iNews and 80 Weather Watch, I'm global meteorologist Nicola Crosby.
Thanks, Nicola. And there is a freezing rain warning in effect. It's -3 right now in Edmonton. Time 8:13, making it news this hour. Mayor Stephen Mandel used Edmonton's veto power against the county of Parkland to stop the rezoning of farmland for industrial use, arguing rezoning would have boxed Edmonton in. Now you can let us know what you think about rezoning farmland right now at iNews80.com. Are you in favor, yes or no, or depends for what reason? The market update now from the iNews80 Business Center. Here is Jane L.
Well, markets are still rather mixed, with the TSX down 25 points to 12,697, the Dow Jones up 24 to 13,998, NASDAQ up 6 to 3205, the Canadian dollar down 58.100 to 99.28, gold down $24.80 to 16.1070, crude oil down $1.70 to 96.20, natural gas up a penny to 3.32. Looking at some of the news this morning, a lot of earnings. Rogers, they beat and raised their dividend by 10%, and their CEO is stepping down by the end of January 2014. TELUS missed on their profits, but they were up 23% on those profits, and they've also raised their dividend payout ratio, so that means that they could increase dividends in the future. Enbridge, their profits were down 8% because of an after-tax charge of $105 million, and they've announced plans for a pipeline from Chicago to the Gulf of Mexico. The IMF came out this morning and said, is suggesting that Canada establish a rainy day fund, similar to that in Alberta and in Quebec. From the iNews80 Business Center, this is Jane Ellis from National Bank Financial.
It's a quarter after 8.